I was commissioned to do these four large-scale paintings for Charles Condé's new restaurant in the Transamerica building in San Francisco. And one canvas in particular was going to be seen as you enter the room. It was going to set the tone for the whole place. And I suggested doing an oversized, larger-than-life sommelier that would greet you as you walked in. And of course, that wasn't the concept that they'd originally asked for. What Charles wanted was warm, calm tavern scenes. But I really wanted to do this one, and I did a comp to show them what the painting was going to look like. And I also did a sketch of the dining room with people sitting at the tables to scale with this giant character looming up behind them. And when Charles saw that, that sealed the deal. He said, oh, we gotta do this. The first painting that I blocked in was the sommelier. And once I had it outlined, I realized how large the wine bottle's label was going to be. It was a very prominent detail. And of course, I love wine and I know a little bit about it, but I don't have the credentials to decide what brand this bottle should be. It's just too important. So I called Charles, who in turn called the sommeliers at some of his other restaurants. He called the one at the Bellagio in Las Vegas and one in San Francisco and one in Southern California. And apparently the sommeliers argued about this for a couple of days. Finally, they settled on Chateau Latour. The only thing is, we've got to decide what year, because the year is big on the label, and there are going to be people eating at this restaurant from all over the world, experts viewing and analyzing this painting, and the year has to be the right year. So finally, Charles called to say they all agree that 1945 was one of the greatest years for Bordeaux and possibly for red wine in all of Europe. And I said, great. It was also the year the war was over. So I've got another good detail for this painting. The lighting was intended to make him look menacing. And I actually, to shoot the reference, I stuck a lamp under my chin and had Barbara take pictures of me so that I could get the lighting. And those guys are often kind of intimidating anyway, so I played it up and made him look just a little more evil. Because, you know, everybody enjoys a good bad guy. The other thing is I like having music in my stories, even if it's just a small detail. So the strolling violinist adds the underscore to the painting. And that particular violinist came out of another painting that I did of a violinist that was playing for tips in the metro in Paris. You can't really tell it, but that guy speaks French. A painting of a realistic scene that has perspective in it is almost like having a window in the room. It makes the room seem larger. So without these paintings, they had these giant wine racks that made the room feel closed in. But once the paintings went on the backs of those, it opened it up. And each one of the paintings had an avenue, a little story that could draw you in. Ultimately, the finished painting was a big hit. It was in a number of magazines. It was on the front cover of the Wine Country News. And just about any review that was done of the restaurant included a visual of this painting. It pretty much became the iconic identity of the restaurant. Because of 9/11, the Transamerica building was designated as a terrorist target, and they intensified security. There were random car searches when you parked in the Transamerica garage, and it drove the restaurant out of business. People just stopped coming, which was kind of sad, but I decided to buy the paintings back, and when I inquired about them, I was told that they were worth three times what I'd been paid for them. But when Charles Condé realized it was me trying to buy them back, he sold them to me for the same price that he had paid, which I thought was very fair. And so we have them, we've still got them, and we'll ultimately sell them individually, and hopefully they will end up where a lot of people can see them. That's what I would like. We do have a print available of the sommelier and any number of paintings that I've done available from the website. You can go to kellervision.tv to find out about work that I've done. You can see what work is available and also see what shows I'll be participating in the future.